Namaste Shiva students, today we are going to start another new chapter of biology, that is chapter 11, transportation in animals and plants. In this chapter we will learn about human circulatory system, that includes blood, blood vessel and heart. Then we will read about human excretory system, then transport of substances in plants, and the last topic is the transpiration, the process of transpiration and its importance. Okay, in everyday language transport means to carry things from one place to another. Okay, but in biology transport is a life process in which a material absorbed or made in one part of the body of an organism is carried to other part in its body. Okay, this point will become clear from the following discussion of the chapter. We have learned earlier that all the living organisms, whether it is animals and plants, need a continuous supply of different materials such as food, water and oxygen for their survival. These materials must reach the various parts of an organism where they are needed. All the living organisms also produce some waste materials like carbon dioxide, okay, as a result of chemical process occurring in their body cells. These waste materials are harmful and have to be removed from the body. So, it is necessary that all the living organisms have some means of transporting or carrying materials from one part to another part within their body. We can now say that all the living organisms, whether it's animals and or plants, need a transport system to supply them with food, water and oxygen and to carry away the harmful waste materials produced in their body. Okay. Here in the figure 11.1, you can see the different organs of or different components of our circulatory system, that is the most important one. This one is the heart, and then you can see the channel like structure shown in the blue and red color. These are all the blood vessels that carries the blood. Okay, so it might be clear to you that in both plants and animals, they have their own transport system for transporting materials within their body. So in this chapter we will learn about the transport system in animals and plants. Let us discuss the transport system in animals first. Okay, the main transport system in human beings is the blood circulatory system, which is commonly known as just circulatory system. In the circulatory system, blood carries digested food, water or oxygen to all the parts of the body. It also take away the waste products like carbon dioxide made in the body cells. Thus the blood circulatory system makes food, water and oxygen available to every part of the body and helps in removing waste materials of the body like carbon dioxide. I hope it is clear to you. Now the various organs of the circulatory system in humans are heart and blood vessels. Blood vessels are of three types: arteries, veins and capillaries. Okay, now blood is also considered a part of the circulatory system. Okay, a student, you must know that in a circulatory system, the heart acts as a pump to push out blood. The blood vessels like arteries, veins and capillaries act as tubes or pipes through which blood flows in the whole body, as the diagram we have shown in the 11.1. okay, now we will describe all the parts of the circulatory system in detail one by one. Let us start with the blood. What happens when you get a cut on your body? I know you can answer. The blood flows out. Now, we must know about that what is blood actually is. You know, students, blood is a red color liquid which flows in blood vessels and circulates in our body. Now, blood is red because it contains a red pigment called hemoglobin. Blood has, you know, many different cells which perform different functions. So we can write that blood consists of four different components. Now, what are those? That are plasma, red blood cells, white blood cells, and platelets. Clear? So the blood is able to transport or carry various substances in the body due to the presence of these different components in it. We will now describe all these four components of blood and their functions in detail. Okay, we'll start with plasma. Now, plasma is a liquid part of the blood. You know, plasma is actually a pale yellow color sticky liquid. Now, it is 90% of water and 3.5% common salt. Plasma contains, you know, dissolved substances such as digested food and waste products like carbon dioxide and urea. This plasma carries water and dissolved substances like, as I said, this digested food and waste products and all that in, you know, from one part of our body to the another part. Now, this red blood cells, white blood cells and platelets are immersed in this liquid that is called plasma. Now, let's talk about this RBC or red blood cells. This red blood cells are red in color due to the presence of the pigment that is called, yes, hemoglobin inside them. You know, this red blood cells carries the oxygen. Now, how can it be possible? Because, this oxygen is carried by the hemoglobin that is present in the red blood cell. That hemoglobin carries this oxygen. This hemoglobin binds with oxygen and transports it to all parts of the body and ultimately to all the cells. You know, if there is a deficiency of hemoglobin in the blood of a person, it becomes difficult to provide oxygen efficiently to all the cells of, that person's body. So, it is the presence of hemoglobin which makes the blood appear red. Please note that. Clear? Now, let's move to the white blood cells. The white blood cells, fight infection and protect us from diseases. This is because, white blood cells help to fight against germs which may enter our bodies and cause diseases. A white blood cell can eat up the germs like bacteria which causes diseases. Now, other white blood cells make chemicals known as antibodies to fight against infection. White blood cells are much smaller in number than the red blood cells. Bujo fell down while playing a game and his knee got injured. It's a very common feature, right? You may have also experienced that. Now, blood was coming out from the cut. After some time, he noticed that bleeding had stopped and the dark red clot had plugged the cut. Bujo was puzzled about this. The clot is formed because of the presence of another type of cells in the blood called platelets. Now, actually, platelets are the tiny fragments of special cells formed in the bone marrow. All these cells, whether it is a red blood cell or this white blood cell or platelets, all are formed in the bone marrow. क्लियर. नाउ प्लेटलेट्स हेल्प इन द क्लॉटिंग ऑफ ब्लड इन अ कट और वुंड. नाउ व्हेन अ कट और वुंड स्टार्ट्स ब्लीडिंग देन प्लेटलेट्स क्लॉट द ब्लड एंड मेक द ब्लड सेमी सॉलिड ड्यू टू विच फर्दर ब्लीडिंग स्टॉप्स. राइट. You know, students, if there were no platelets in the blood, then bleeding caused by a cut from an injury would not stop. This may cause loss of too much blood from the body of a person and that may lead to death also. So, here you can see the different components of blood as I have discussed just now. The plasma is the pale yellow color, sticky liquid. Then are these small fragments are there, that is the platelets. Then is the red blood cells and white blood cell. And you can see the picture given, it shows the real how they look. I will conclude this video after discussing once again the main function of the blood, and I will ask you to write down as I am telling you the point wise, okay, in your bio note copy. So write down the important function of the blood. Number one, blood carries digested food from the small intestine to all the parts of the body. Second point, blood carries water to all the parts of the body. Third point, blood carries oxygen from the lungs to different parts of the body. Fourth point, blood carries the waste product carbon dioxide from the body cells to the lungs for breathing out. Next point, blood carries a waste product called urea from the liver to the kidneys for excretion in urine. And then the last one, blood protects the body from diseases. We know this is because white blood cells, kill the bacteria and other germs which cause diseases. I hope it is clear to you. Today up to this, in my next video, I will discuss about various blood vessels. Namah Shivaya.